back to the next session of design of pre-stressed concrete elements course. So we'll start with module number 3 in this session. So module number 3 deals with design of sections for flexure. So in module number 3 we are going to learn the following aspects, that is analysis of members at ultimate strength. So before leading into the design part, so first let me go ahead with analysis of members at ultimate strength. And one more part we are going to deal in the module number 3 is preliminary and final design for type 1 member. Specifically, they have been mentioned for type 1 members. So with this, let me get into the module number 3. So as I stated, before going with these design aspects, so let me go ahead with this analysis of members at ultimate strength first. So let me start analysis of members. So mainly analysis of members at ultimate strength means, so we are going to analyze the members or section under flexure. So in the module number 1 also, we have analyzed the section, a various section under bending. Okay, by subjecting to the various types of gravity loads, and also in addition to the gravity loads, we have been subjected to the pre-stressing force. So in continuation with this, let us go ahead within this module number 3, that is analysis of section under flexure. So before going to that, let me introduce the topic. So we know that a PSC member usually remains uncracked under service load. So under service load, so this particular PSC member is uncracked under what condition? So this analysis under service load is assumed to be, okay, the material to be linearly elastic. That means here if I draw the stress strain curve, okay, if I draw the stress strain curve for a material, then I'm going to assume that this will be, okay, linear, I can say. So this particular thing will be linear. The stress strain pattern will be linear. Okay, so that is what the assumption, okay, or I can say the condition it states. So it will be linear. Okay, so this will be the stress and this will be the, okay, the strain. Okay, this will be the stress and this will be the strain. So now, so under this condition, that means if I'm going to analyze the PSC member under service load, it will be uncracked by a condition. That means if the material assumed to be linearly elastic, so at that particular condition, the PSC member will remain uncracked. Did you get my point? Fine. So after, once the beam gets cracked, or I can say after get cracking, the member gets cracked, the behavior of PSC member will be similar to the non-pre-stressed RC member. So please note this point. After cracking, the behavior of PSC member is similar to non-pre-stressed PSC member or pre-stressed concrete member. Did you get my point? Now, if I'm going to increase the load, okay, then automatically this, whatever the linear stress strain relationship have been obtained for uncracked. So once if it is cracked, or this particular condition will come once I'm going to increase the load. So the condition which was uncracked, as the load increased, okay, so immediately, so this will go to the, okay, cracking zone. Did you get my point? So once, if this particular load is increased, okay, then the stress versus strain behavior of concrete becomes non-linear. That means, okay, it will start entering to the plastic zone. Did you get my point? Okay, so this is a small understanding, okay, or we need to know, because what we are actually analyzing, we must know, okay, before proceeding to the analysis of a section. Did you get my point? So I will repeat. So now the PSC member will be uncracked, okay, under service load, okay, during a condition if the material is linearly elastic. So once the beam will get cracked, that means the behavior will be, or behavior of PSC member will be similar to the non-pre-stressed, that means reinforced concrete member. Okay, so with increasing load, so this non-linear stress strain relationship will be obtained. Okay, so this is a small, okay, the introduction part I've been explained. Next, so as I stated, or what we are going to do here in this particular module, the analysis of pre-stressed concrete member for ultimate strength is similar to that of reinforced concrete member. Okay, so whatever the analysis I'm going to do, so basically I'm going to analyze for this cracking condition. Did you get my point? So after cracking, okay, I'm going to analyze this condition. Okay, so the analysis of PSC member for ultimate strength, is similar to reinforced concrete member. The analysis aims to calculate, what is the meaning of analysis? What exactly we are going to do in analysis? The analysis, what we are going to do is calculating the ultimate moment capacity or ultimate moment of resistance of the pre-stressed concrete member. So that is what the meaning of analysis, and that is what we are going to do in this particular module. That is 3.1, what I have been stated, that is analysis of PSC member under flexure. Okay, so that part deals with, that means the analysis deals with calculating the ultimate moment capacity. So, okay, so this is a small introduction. So now, so let me go with some more basics. Okay, let you know that the PSC member, or I can say any member, a rectangular member. Okay, once if I'm going to subject to the concentrated load or whatever the loads, okay, two-point load which I'm going to subject. Okay, so now the flexure part. Okay, now you came to know the analysis part. What exactly is the meaning of flexure? So now if I'm going to subject this particular the concrete member, that is preferably PSC member, subjected to two-point load, then this particular beam will undergo bending like this. So this particular beam will undergo bending like this. Am I right? Okay, so this will undergo the bending like this. Okay, so now once or when the beam is subjected to bending or flexure, okay, what will be the ultimate moment capacity of a member? So that is what this 3.1 deals with. So you already know that when a PSC member or any member subjected to the two-point loading, okay, then the member will undergo deformation. Okay, that means it will be subjected to bending. So that is the meaning of flexure. And also you people have done this experiment in your basic concrete and our concrete material testing lab. You have been casted the concrete beam and you have been subjected that beam to the two-point loading. So there you have been, okay, subjected that concrete beam preferably to the bending, okay, under two-point loading. Did you get my point? Okay, and regarding that compression zone, tension zone, all those things I'm going to explain next. Okay, so because whatever we people have been learnt in reinforced concrete member, so the same thing will be continued here itself. Okay, or here also I can say. Okay, so what we've been learnt is the analysis of section. Analysis means I'm going to analyze the PSC member just like a reinforced concrete member, that is after cracking. Okay, that means I'm going to calculate the ultimate moment capacity, or ultimate moment of resistance when the member subjected to the bending, that is what flexure. Okay, so this is what I can say regarding your a small introduction part, okay, to your what I can say to the introduction part of this analysis. Okay, so with this introduction, so any analysis if you're going to perform for a PSC member, any analysis if you're going to perform for a PSC member, so then basically we need to follow certain assumptions. So what are those assumptions? Okay, so as it states, the analysis of member under flexure for ultimate strength, the following assumptions were considered. That means when I'm going to analyze any PSC member under flexure for ultimate strength. So this is a very, very important thing. So that's what I've been discussed here. Okay, see, till here, okay, so I've been analyzed or been considered the material will be elastic. So no cracking will come into the picture. So once the beam has shown the cracking, that means I'm going to analyze the beam at ultimate strength or till its failure. Okay, so after cracking, so whatever the analysis I'm going to do under flexure, so will be same as that of a reinforced concrete member. So that's what, okay, the introduction part have been discussed. Okay, so that is the meaning of ultimate strength. Okay, so next. So let me go ahead with the first one. Now, the first assumption, okay, the same assumption, what we stated in the module number one, once we are doing analysis of a section, okay, that is the plane section remains plane, okay, till the ultimate state or till the failure. I will repeat, plane section. So I've been also explained how it exactly it will be there, perpendicular to the axis of the member, okay, remains plane till the ultimate state, or I can say failure. So ultimate state can also be okay stated as failure. Okay, so the plane section perpendicular to the axis of the member remains plane till the ultimate state or failure. Did you get my point? So next, so that is the first assumption, and this assumption is also called as Bernoulli's hypothesis. So this assumption, we have used to say it as a Bernoulli's hypothesis. The plane section remains plane till the ultimate state or failure. Next, the second assumption is there should be a perfect bond should be retained between the concrete and the pre-stressing steel for bonded tendons. So the second assumption says that, okay, whatever the, okay, the bonding, okay, that will be there between the concrete and the pre-stressing steel, it should be retained. And you already know that why it should retain, because if any PSC member, wants to, okay, any PSC member subject to the any load, okay, or the whatever the flexural effect, okay, because of that flexural effect, if it possesses that tensile stresses, so those tensile stresses effectively resisted or counteracted by the bonding between the concrete and the pre-stressing steel. So once if this bonding fails, okay, then the pre-stressed concrete will not come into the picture. So that's what, okay, the second assumption, there should be a perfect bond between the concrete and the pre-stressing steel. Okay. The next, the third assumption is the tension in the concrete is neglected. The third assumption is whatever the tension that will be there, okay, that will be neglected. Next, the design stress versus strain curve for concrete and steel are considered. Okay, the design, that means whatever the design, okay, we are going to do for the members under flexure. So that stress versus strain curves for concrete and steel will be considered in order to go ahead with the design. Okay, so these are all the assumptions I'm going to consider for analysis of member under flexure for ultimate strength. Is it clear? Okay, so hope you understand the assumptions part, and also, okay, whatever the, okay, introduction part have been discussed. So with this, let me proceed with the next topic. The next topic says like this. So once if the beam is subjected to flexural effect, or I can say the bending, if a PSC member subjected to the bending, there will be various types of failure. Okay, or I can say the various types of flexural failure. Okay, so the next topic deals with the types of flexural failure. So what are the various types of flexural failures that will be encountered in the PSC members? Okay, when the PSC beam subjected to the bending or flexure, what are the failures that will be encountered in the PSC member? So let us discuss one by one. So number one, fracture of steel in tension. Fracture of steel in tension. Okay, so this is the first type of failure you are going to come across, mainly with the material failure, that is fracture of steel in tension. So let us discuss that. Now, this particular failure is going to happen in such a way that there will be a sudden failure of PSC member without any warning. Is generally happen due to the fracture of steel in tension zone. So whatever the steel that will be embedded in the tension zone, so those steel will undergo the fracture or enormous elongation. Okay, so once it get elongates, then there will be a sudden failure. So now, why this type of failure is going to happen? What is the cause for this type of failure? So this type of failure is imminent when the whatever the percentage of steel that is provided or embedded in the section is so low or less than when the concrete in the tension zone cracks. Okay, that means whatever the steel I'm going to provide or whatever the steel prescribed or minimum steel prescribed, okay, if I'm going to provide lesser than that particular steel or percentage of steel at that particular instance, these type of fracture of steel or failure is going to happen. Did you get my point? When the percentage of steel or whatever the steel provided in the tension zone, if those, okay, steel, okay, which has been provided or which has been embedded in the tensile zone, if it is less than the prescribed or minimum, then this type of failure. And what is the, what I can say, the performance I can say, or how the steel will fail? The steel is not in a position to bear up the additional tensile stresses transferred to it by the cracked concrete. So now, please observe here. So this is a beam. Okay. So now what is going to happen here? So now it is the bending. Okay, I've been written the bending. So now whatever the steel have been embedded inside this. Whatever the steel have been embedded inside this. Okay. So this steel, if it is less than the prescribed, less than the minimum that need to be take care of these tensile stresses inside the PSC member, okay, if it's lesser than that particular prescribed, then the steel is not in a position to bear the tensile stresses created by, okay, the external load, okay, by the external load, okay, because of this external load, the tensile stresses will be developed. Those tensile stresses, okay, will be create, okay, the effect on this steel, so that steel is not in a position to bear the additional tensile stresses. So hence, immediately, as we know, the steel which is bonded to the concrete, okay, then the steel, okay, which is unbearable about the tensile stresses, will transfer those tensile stresses to the concrete. Okay, so did you get my point? So it will transfer the tensile stresses to the concrete. So now, as we know, the concrete which is weak in tension, so immediately the concrete will undergo crack, and finally there will be a sudden failure of a pre-stressed concrete member. Did you get my point? So this is the first type of flexural failure that is going to happen. That is inefficiency of steel because of lesser percentage of steel provided. Okay, so there is a first type of failure. So now how to overcome this type of failure then? How to overcome this type of failure? Then, so this type of failure can be prevented by providing a certain minimum percentage of steel. Okay, I need to go ahead with a minimum percentage of steel in the cross section. So this is the solution. Okay, I can go ahead in order to prevent the fracture of steel. So whatever the steel I was providing, okay, which was very low, okay, which is lesser than the prescribed. So in order to overcome that, if I'm going to provide a minimum percentage of steel in the cross section, so then I can overcome this type of failure in the under flexure. Did you get my point? So what is that minimum percentage? The code specifies, the Indian standard code IS 1343. So as I stated, there will be two codes, that is 1980-2012, so it is an improved version, prescribes a minimum longitudinal reinforcement of 0.2%, okay, 0.2% of the cross-sectional area. Okay, so this will be the steel I'm going to provide, minimum steel, 0.2% of the cross-sectional area. Okay, in all the cases, except in the case of pretension units of smaller section, because in the smaller section it is not feasible to provide this, so there you can reduce the steel. Okay, so this will hold for, I can say, the mild steel. So when I'm going with the HYST bar, because nowhere we are going with the mild steel nowadays, so when I'm going with the HYST bar, that is high yield strength deformation bar, that is 415, 500, 550, something like that, then the minimum percentage of steel should be reduced to 0.15%. Okay, for HYST bar, it is 0.15% of steel I need to go at. Okay, so now if I'm going to provide the minimum percentage of this 0.15 for HYST and 0.2% for mild steel, then I can take care of this type of, okay, failure. Is it clear? So this is the first type of flexural failure you're going to observe. Okay, coming to the next one. The next one says like this. The second type of flexural failure you're going to see is, okay, failure of flexural member or failure of PSC member under flexure due to the under reinforced section. Okay, so as we know, what is the meaning of balanced section, what is the meaning of under reinforced section, and what is the meaning of over reinforced section, okay, while you are studying your design of RC elements course. So in that particular case, they have been clearly discussed what is under reinforced, what is over reinforced, and what is balanced. So once again, I'm going to, okay, repeat, or once again, I'm going to discuss this under reinforced section, particularly in with respect to the PSC member. Okay, so let us discuss once again. So now, if the cross section of a PSC member is provided with an amount of steel, okay, so because in the first, I've been provided the steel lesser than the minimum. Now, I'm going to provide an amount of steel greater than the minimum percentage as prescribed in case number one. Greater than the minimum, that means, so this is the minimum percentage. Then the failure is characterized by, then how it will, the failure is going to happen under info section. The failure is characterized by excessive elongation of steel followed by crushing of concrete. Okay, why there will be excessive elongation of steel? Why the steel will undergo what I can say, enter to the plastic region or enter to the ultimate region, or excessive elongation is going to happen? Because once if the loads are increased, as the bending loads are increased, the excessive elongation of steel rises, the neutral axis closer to the compression phase or the critical section. So very, very important. So now you need to observe. So whatever the thing I have been explained here. So now, so this will be the neutral axis and what this will be the steel I have been provided. So now under reinforced section it will be, okay, consider in such a way that, okay, will be discussed in such a way that, so whatever the steel that will be embedded inside the PSC member, so those steel will be more than the minimum percentage of steel. And then once the load is increased, once the load will increase, so this bending will keep on increase. Am I right? So this bending will keep on increase. Okay. So if the bending is increased, then the steel is unbearable. That means excessive, because this external load will try to create tensile stresses at the bottom. So as I stated, so these tensile stresses, okay, whatever the steel provided, okay, will be taken care to a certain limit only. If that steel, okay, unbearable, then there will be excessive elongation. Because of excessive elongation, it will start showing the cracks at the midpoint, okay, mainly at this zone. Okay, you can see here. So the flexural crack will be initiated here from the soffit of the member. So once the crack has been initiated, then whatever the neutral axis that was there, okay, which was balancing, that is C is equal to T, okay, because of this excessive elongation, particularly in under reinforced section, this neutral axis will shift or move towards the compression phase. Okay, because of this excessive elongation in steel, okay, because of increase in load, it will undergo enormous bending. The neutral axis, which was there at the center, will undergo shift towards the compression phase. Then, once the neutral axis shift towards the top, then automatically the concrete once again will not able to bear those tensile stresses, which will be transferred by the steel on the concrete. Then the failure is going to happen through crushing of concrete. Okay, and this type of failure you are going to see commonly in any type of beams and slab. So this is what the failure, and whatever the design we are going to do or perform for any flexural member, we are going to do in such a way that, so those failure is going to happen in this way of under reinforced failure. So please note this point. And these, okay, things you have been learned in your RC section. So once again, I'm repeating here. Okay, so whatever the beam you are designing, you are make the beam to fail under reinforced section or under reinforced failure. Okay, here it should give a warning. See, steel, once it is unbearable, that means excessive elongation take place, okay, the crack will be initiated. The crack will start initiating. And whatever the crack that has been initiated, it will move towards the compression zone. Why? Because the neutral axis will try to shift towards upwards. Okay, then the concrete will be unbearable and the crushing is going to, or crushing failure is going to happen. So that is what, okay, I've been explained here. Okay, now in continuation with whatever I've been explained, okay, I've been written here, the member approaches failure, okay, due to the gradual reduction of compression. That's what I've been told, because shift in the neutral axis, because of shift of the neutral axis, the compression zone will be keep on reduces and tension zone will keep on increases because of excessive or enormous elongation of steel. Okay, because of this, it will exhibit, that means the PSC members will exhibit large deflection and cracks, which will be developed at the soffit and progress towards the compression phase. when the area of the concrete in the compression zone is insufficient to resist the internal compressive force, the ultimate flexural failure of the member takes place through the crushing of concrete. So that's what I've been explained. Did you get my point? So hope you have understood. So whatever I've been explained, okay, the same thing I've been written here. So once, okay, if the member has been subjected to the external load, okay, which try to develop the tensile stresses, so those tensile stresses will be taken care by the steel. Okay, once if the load is keep on increases, then the bending will keep on increased, so that the excessive elongation of steel is going to take place. Because of this excessive elongation of steel, the neutral axis will try to shift. Okay, that means the tension zone will try to increase and the compression zone will be reduced. Because of this, the large deflection and crack will be observed at the soffit. And these cracks will be progressed towards the compression phase. So this is what the failure. Okay, you can see here. So the crack will be initiated here first. Okay, and it will be progressed towards this. Okay, and progress towards this. So this type of failure is called flexural failure, or I can say the flexural tension failure. Not only it will be narrow, sometimes it will be, okay, diagonal cracks also. Sometimes this will be called as flexural shear failure because of the shear. Because if you are not going to provide any stirrups, proper stirrups, then you can see the flexural shear, okay, shear failures. Did you get my point? Okay, so this is regarding your under info section, and hope you know that, okay, whatever the design you are going to do, okay, practically we are making the flexural member to fail under this under info section only. That means it should give a lot of warnings. It should give a lot of warnings. So those warning will be in terms of deflection and cracking. So it will show the enormous warning. So with these warnings, I'm going to taken care of this beam, okay, or prevent, okay, whatever the action I need to take. Did you get my point? Fine. So let me go with the next type of flexural failure. The next type of flexural failure is failure of a PSC member under over-reinforced section condition. Okay. Okay, as the name itself indicates, you can clearly see what is the meaning of over-reinforced section. When the effective reinforcement index, now in PSC we used to call it as effective reinforcement index, but in the case of RC member we used to call it as a percentage of reinforcement or reinforcement ratio. Okay, so when the percentage of reinforcement, okay, the compressive strength of the concrete and the tensile strength of the steel exceeds the certain range of values, that means whatever the reinforcement I am going to provide, okay, so if those reinforcement if going to provide more than the limiting percentage, that means if PT, so this is the meaning, is if PT, that is percentage of steel provided, is more than the, okay, PT limb, okay, that means I'm going to provide the enormous steel, okay, so this condition is called over reinforced condition. So at that particular instance, the compressive strength of concrete and tensile strength of a steel exceeds the certain, that means the minimum, okay, certain range of values, then the section is said to be over reinforced. That means whatever the reinforce I'm going to provide, that reinforcement, if it exceeds enormously, okay, then you can observe the failure of this over reinforced section failure. So let us know how it is going to fail. In over-reinforced member, it will fail by sudden crushing of concrete. Failure being characterized by small deflection and narrow cracks. So once again, here also, when PT, that is percentage of reinforcement provided, okay, is more than the limiting reinforcement, then the steel, whatever have been provided, okay, because of that more PT, so whatever the reinforcement will be unbearable, okay, then whatever the load, external load have been subjected, the concrete, okay, will be unbearable. So this concrete once again will undergo sudden failure. Please note this point. Okay, sudden failure. Okay, okay, or sudden crushing failure, I can say, or crushing of concrete. Okay, here also the same thing. Once, okay, if the external load has been subjected on the PSC member, okay, you can see this particular cracks will be initiated the soffit, and these whatever the cracks that has been initiated will be narrow compared to that previous one, and this will be extended towards the compression phase. Okay, once if it is extended towards the compression phase, the concrete will be unbearable and there will be sudden failure of concrete. Okay, there will be sudden failure of concrete. I can say sudden crushing of concrete. Did you get my point? So this is regarding over reinforced section. Okay, so in under reinforced section, okay, whatever the steel I'm going to provide, okay, it will give a warning. In the first case, it is lesser than the minimum. In the third case, if it is more than the, what I can say, minimum, that means enormous. Enormous, if I'm going to steel provide it in order to take care of these tensile stresses, then the it will be overburdened in the PSC member. Because of this, there will be crushing failure. Okay, and also, as I have been stated, this over reinforced section will create sudden failure of a PSC beam or member. Did you get my point? Okay, and nowhere, okay, remember, or you should not come across with these type of failure, or we should not design a PSC member or any RC member with respect to over reinforced. Always we need to go ahead with any design of member, that is whether it may be PSC member or it may be a reinforced concrete member, we need to go ahead with under reinforced, okay, section failure. Did you get my point? Okay, so this is regarding your things. Okay, and as I stated, okay, we are going to perform the analysis of a member for the following section, that is for rectangular section and also for the flanger sections, so which I am going to discuss in the next class. Okay, so this is the type of flexural failure which I'm going to come across in the case of PSC member. Okay, so in this particular session, I've been discussed what are the assumptions I need to consider and what exactly we are going to perform in the analysis of section. Okay, so as I stated, okay, we are going to do for a after cracking, that is at ultimate strength. We are going to consider the member at ultimate strength and we are going to perform the analysis. So as I stated, analysis means calculating the ultimate moment of resistance under flexure. Flexural means under bending. Did you get my point? So these things have been discussed in this particular session. So with this, let me analyze the various types of section, that is rectangular section, flanged section, in the next session. So with this, I'm going to, okay, end this particular session. So hope you understood this session. So thank you.